Our next speaker will be Shripad Gade. He's from the Aerospace Engineering of UIUC. His topic will be robotic herding of bird flocks using UAVs.
Hey, hello guys. I hope you have had a great day of talks here at CSL. So my name is Shripad. I'm a second year PhD student in the Aerospace Engineering Department. And I'll be talking today about robotic herding of bird flocks using UAVs. So this is just a brief outline of my talk. I'll be spending a little bit of time on the motivation, a little bit on the problem formulation, and then I'll present to you the solution that we have come up with and some of our results. So to start with the motivation, I'll have a video.
Airways Flight 1549 has just left New York's LaGuardia Airport.
Birds.
And that... The plane is falling from the sky.
We're going to be in the Hudson.
Well, as you might have heard, so in this US Airways flight 1549, what happened was that the aircraft engine had ingested a flock of birds, resulting into total engine failure. Both of the engines failed, and they had to crash land into the Hudson River. And that gives us a pretty good motivation for why we are interested in pursuing this topic. More than just that one individual incident, what we should also realize is that there are many bird strikes than you might imagine. So every year, the U.S. aviation industry loses more than $400 million and more than $1.2 billion worldwide due to, operational losses or because the aircraft gets damaged. Between 1990 and 2013, there were more than 142,000 wildlife strikes in the at U.S. airports, and more than 11,000 of them occurred just in 2013. And birds were involved in 97% of the reported cases. So we now know that we have a problem, and we would like to have some kind of a solution. So let's look at what methods are present right now. So one of the most effective methods that has been around is the use of real falcons. So the US Air Force uses well-trained falcons to kind of attack these bird flocks and try to ensure that none of the military aircrafts suffer these kind of bird strikes. But one of the problems, other than being extremely expensive, is that these falcons are also endangered species. So it's not exactly a scalable solution, and we would probably not be able to deploy it everywhere. So one of the other solutions that people have come up with is using a remote-controlled airplane. So there's this company called Clear Flight Solution. It used to be called GreenX. So they have this robotic bird that they tried, they used to scare birds away from airports. So, the solution that we are trying to propose is to have a fully autonomous robotic bird or a falcon, which would essentially try to scare birds away from the airports into zones that are, safe for both the birds and the aircraft. So now we know that there's this problem, and we would like to abstract a simpler problem, something that we can study, for which we can propose solutions and give some guarantees. So for this talk and for this work, we would define herding as the control of an animal group by a pursuer. So this pursuer is, in our case, the robotic falcon, and it could be any robot for that matter. And we assume that the herding occurs because there's a controlled predator-prey interaction. So there's an inherent assumption underlying here that these animal flocks or animal groups are afraid of the predators, and we are going to capitalize on that. And so for this problem, we will have these herding goals where we would ideally want to divert a flock towards a safe point that is far away from the airport, We would want to avoid flock fragmentation because having a flock is bad enough, and you know, having two is like worse. We would also want to avoid collision with the birds because it's a safety constraint. We don't want to harm some of these migrating birds. There are some herding metrics which would be more relevant towards the later part of the talk. So we'll try to see how the flock behaves by trying to, you know, see how the flock centroid moves or the flock diameter changes. So the flock diameter here is a bounding ball that will, you know, capture all of the birds. Then we'll try to tag these parameters to show how well the method is. So there have been some methods that have been proposed in the past two decades or so regarding controlling of group of animals, groups of robots. The most relevant one of them is a very recent paper by Strombaum, which came out in 2014, where they implanted GPS chips on sheep and dogs and tried to see how a sheepdog actually goes and tries to herd the sheep. And then they tried to get some heuristics out of them and presented those as a part of their results. So keeping this in mind, what we would be interested in this problem is that instead of having a group of herding agents, which is common in this kind of field, we would ideally want to have only a single herding agent. And we would like to give some kind of theoretical proofs and some kind of guarantees, because those are currently not available in the literature. And we would also like to see if, you know, we can extract some relationship between the flock shapes, their sizes, their behavior, and between the herding algorithms that we propose. So to begin with, the first roadblock that we're going to face is how do we model the flock? There has been significant amount of work in this field in the past three decades or so after the work by Stitsiklis in 1984, a lot of new methods have been proposed. So what we'll be doing is that we'll be using a double integrator model for the birds. So essentially there's this position, you differentiate it, you get velocity. You differentiate velocity, you get acceleration. And we generate this flock by allowing each of the birds by to have these four or five steers, which essentially give them guidance. So the first term is essentially a separating steer. It is modeled like a consensus term, and it essentially tries to create a uniform separation between any two birds. So you know those two birds will never collide in between, you know, with each other. There's an alignment term that tries to ensure that all of the individual birds try to move in the same direction. So you know there is cohesion in the entire group. There's a goal term, the third term, which essentially is, you know, like a goal that is intrinsic to each and every bird. So it's almost like saying that they know where their nest is or where the food source is, and they would all ideally want to move in that direction. So we try to model that behavior through the third term. And there is this fourth fear term, which is probably the most interesting one for us, because we'll be using this term to try to herd the bird flock. So the fear in this case is modeled as a composite behavior between two separate behaviors. First one of them is that when you see that there's a predator coming towards you, you would ideally want to move directly, you know, in the opposite direction. Just, you know, try to evade it. And there's this also other kind of behavior where, you know, if the predator is way close to you, you would ideally want to move in a exactly perpendicular manner. Try to outmaneuver it, because some of these birds are small and they are much more maneuverable than falcons or, let's say, any other kind of predators. So this is the flocking algorithm or the model that we'll be using throughout. So for this kind of a model, there are some stability results already present. The more popular ones are by Alpha T. Saber that came out in 2006 and one by Tanner that came out in 2007. We extended some of these results to give exponential stability. They're not included in this talk, but they can be seen in our paper. So now we move to the solution. We know that there's a problem. We have abstracted a simpler problem out of it, and now we're proposing an algorithm that would allow us to gain control over this flock. So the algorithm that we are proposing is a boundary-based algorithm. So here, the robotic falcon would act only on the boundary of the flock and would never penetrate it. So what would happen is that the UAV would ideally move in some kind of an arc, as shown in the figure, something like this, which will ensure that it does not collide with any one of these birds, and also ensures that the flock does not break into two if you move just on the boundary of the flock. And so this boundary that we are interested in is called the front, and we'll be proposing algorithm to select this boundary out of the entire flock. So selection of this front depends on two important points, and the first one being the herding goal, which is the location where you would want the flock to move to, and the second one is a boundary, the boundary that you would ideally want to protect. This is the airspace close to your airport, and based on this, we would select our front and go ahead with the algorithm. So the first part of it essentially tells you how you select these how you select this front. So here what you would be doing is we'll choose the birds that are closest to the boundary. So these are the ones that are the which pose the maximum threat, and we'll select ones that are the farthest away from the goal. So these are the ones that you would ideally want to push. So if you want to make the flock go in this direction or move towards the goal. So that constitutes the first part, which essentially tells us how you're going to select the front. And the second part is essentially what you do once you have the front. You would ideally want the UAV to have some kind of guidance and control that would allow the UAV to track the front and essentially push the flock in the desired direction. So the second part, the guidance algorithm, is pretty simple. You move towards the flock with full speed till you reach the front, and once you reach the front, you move in that move in the arc-like fashion, try to achieve your objectives without disintegrating the flock. So one of the important results that we have is a stability result, which essentially tells us if you want to implement such a strategy, how aggressive should you be, or how aggressive should the falcon be, so that you will be able to solve the objective yet not cause any problems. So the result essentially tells us how the front should be created. So if you have a flock like this, where each of the individual dot represents a bird, and this is the distance beyond which, the red line is the distance beyond which the flock does not care if there's a falcon or if there's no falcon. So the stability theorem essentially tells us how aggressively can you penetrate this envelope, and in what direction should you penetrate so that you will be able to herd the flock in a desired direction. So this is one of the simulation test cases where you have a flock, the boundary of which is given by this, and you want the flock to be moved to this direction. So what you would do is that you would force the predator to be in this magenta track, and that would ensure that we move this flock towards the goal and yet do not break the flock. So there are some more simulation results that we have where there's this hexagonal flock shape that needs to be directed towards this goal. And the inherent tendency of this flock is to move towards this flock destination. So we can assume that there's an airport somewhere close by, and you would ideally want this flock to be pushed in this direction instead of this direction. And the magenta track shown over here shows the kind of trajectories that the falcon would take to solve the herding problem. There's another simulation case. Important thing to notice here would be that the flock wanted to move in this direction, and the herding goal was somewhere here. So eventually the system settles into a state where the falcon kind of creates a bounding surface or a hyperplane, and then tries to ensure that the flock does not breach it. So in conclusion, we proved that the pursuer can asymptotically herd the flock using the n-wavefront algorithm. And we derive some sufficient bounds on the push distance and approach direction. These are really important for us, because if you do not honor the stability requirement that you have, you would either cause the flock to fragment, or you would cause the flock to spill over. As in this case, the flock would kind of spill over and move towards the flock destination irrespective. It would essentially go just past you. And then we showed some numerical simulations to show stable herding. So some of our work here was captured in these two magazines. You could probably read them up later if you are interested. Also, since I have time, I would show you another video. Work done in our lab, which essentially towards building such a robotic falcon that will be able to solve this problem. Notice that there are several extra degrees of freedom, as in, a standard UAV would have flat wings, as in the ones that don't have any articulation at all. Here you can see that the wings bend in between as well as they can twist, and such structure into the UAV is going to give us capability to aggressively maneuver, which would be important in missions like these, where safety is of paramount importance. With this, I think I'd conclude, and I'll be open for questions.
Are there any questions?
Yeah.
When the Air Force now is training the real Falcons, how do they herd the flocks? Do they also create that front, or how do they?
No. So what the strategy that they use is just to teach the falcon, or rather let it run by its own instinct, just to go towards the flock and break it if necessary.
So just, does it penetrate the flock, or what's the...
Yeah, it will penetrate if it has to. So the thing is that since most of the Air Force bases are kind of outside the city limits, you would not see a lot of organized flock activity. The algorithms that I presented would be useful in a case where you have, let us say, 50 birds or let us say 40 birds coming towards you. But if you have just two birds of them, maybe an aggressive pursuit would be enough. So, yeah.
Let's have one more question.
Yeah.
Have you considered the case where if a real predator comes in and wants you, you're
just going to do all that? Yeah, though we are not looking at that case, although it will be... Yeah, because the thing is that in such a case, the falcon would probably also attack the real falcon would attack the robotic falcon, because typically this is the behavior that you see. If you take a flapping wing bird and try to fly it in an open ground, you are invariably going to attract attention from other birds. This is something that you can empirically see. So I would guess that something similar would happen.